for better or worse. We live in a world that is dominated by sampling, charcuterie boards, crudité, buffets, and sampler platters. These are the samples that we're living with, and it does translate into yo-yo, for better or worse, if you can believe it. In the last 6 months, Jeffrey Pang has had his hand on at least 5 releases, including our yo-yo for today. And it is a bit of a remix. Take a little bit of this and that and add something to make something a little more special. And what a remix. What we're going to discover today is that sometimes, even in yo-yos, there are times when the sum is greater than its parts. And honestly, I think Jeffrey saved the best for last. But just like the music has a remix, we're going to check out the remix for this yo-yo. Today we're looking at the hybrid Fovea from Luftwerk and Jeffrey Pang. And I have to say, ooh, this thing is nice. I have to admit, I'm surprised and happy that this thing came into existence. Aesthetically speaking, it's always been on point with Mr. Pang. But is there more to this yo-yo than just its looks? Previous entries include the 000, which we reviewed already. Very nice. A dope organic to be sure, and this thing was clean. There was enough units also so that you didn't have to make a choice between the fully plastic Fovea or the 000. Despite the number of units, a division did rise. Were you a 000 person or a plastic Fovea one? Personally, I leaned a little more towards the plastic Fovea, only because it was a little better performing than the 000. And just as a recap, the 000 is a little bit more floaty, whereas the plastic Fovea is a bit more technical, a little more performance oriented. But both of these complement each other very well. The hybrid, however, puts me in the mind of sequels that are better than the original, like The Godfather 2, The Empire Strikes Back, T2 Judgment Day, Mad Max Fury Road, Spider-Man 2, and of course we cannot forget the iconic Dark Knight. Our hybrid Fovea is part of a rare occurrence where a sequel yo-yo is actually better than the original. Some other rarities include the Shutter Evo, which is better than the original, the Titanium Dunk, which they say is the best version of the Dunk, and although I was a huge fan of the Countach, they say the 5000 QV is even better, but I wouldn't know because I didn't play that too much. Then we have the original Speedaholic, which is outdone by a large margin by the Double X. I'm not going to go there between the Surveillance and the Surveil. However, since it's not fair to compare, I will say that the Surveil is pretty significant in this review, and we'll discuss its significance and how it relates to our current hybrid, the Fovea, in just a second. In the meantime, check the stats. The dimensions are pretty much on point with the original plastic Fovea, but there is a 0.3 gram difference in weight. But that's not the whole story. So let's check out this unboxing. This simple presentation does keep costs down, which I appreciate. A little simplified, but it gets the job done because the yo-yo arrived to me in pristine condition. After opening it, I'm immediately hit by how much light this thing throws back at you. Very striking. And I was surprised to see that it is pretty clear down in the body. I thought it would be a bit more frosted because the pictures made it look that way. But here are the boxes, all similar. So, even before this yo-yo arrived, I thought this might be the most significant hybrid since the iceberg. If we recall, the iceberg was an excellent yo-yo and marked a noticeable shift in hybrids due to materials and design. And I think it represented a benchmark in what hybrid yo-yos could achieve. But this yo-yo outdoes it in one key area. So here we have the 000. I'm not going to talk too much, just listen. The Fovea is a little quieter. The Surveil is quieter still. But notice our Fovea. It is whisper quiet. Check this out. Check out the blog over at Lutverk for the full skinny. But what we're dealing with here is a step away from a heavy metal axle system to an injection molded center with a light captive nut. Now that's an old school way of doing things, which is pretty effective. Jeffrey said he wanted to capture that yo-yo jam feel from years ago, and I can dig it. That's also why the rims are raw aluminum, so you can expect marks and a little patina as the years go by, but there will be anodized rims in the future runs of this yo-yo. Personally, again, I love how this thing grabs light. Still surprised by how clear the body is. I thought it would be more frosted like the Speedaholic Double X, but sometimes you gotta let a little string shine through. And we will be stringing this up real soon. But the pictures on Lutverk's website don't do this thing justice. It is absolutely gorgeous. And what you're seeing is a pretty accurate representation. Another notable feature about this yo-yo is its spin. This thing is pretty powerful. However, its power is a little more subdued. It's not in your face, but it's there. Because I'm averaging about 4 minutes per spin on this yo-yo. With a nice clean throw. And we were tripping on how smooth the plastic Fovea was, but would you believe that the hybrid is even smoother? I have zero vibe on a fingernail test. On a good throw, solid throw, man, this thing doesn't even feel like it's spinning. I have opened this thing up a couple of times, and each time I have, it still stays smooth. But what you really want to know is, how does this thing play? And this is where our Surveil comes in at, because I don't have an iceberg. But this is the closest thing to it, which is a one-on-one pretty much for the most part. And if we remember, the Surveil does play powerfully. Not sluggish, but it is heavier when compared to our hybrid Fovea. There's a lot going on with the rims of the Surveil. And it is all compacted into a smaller unit, making for a little more dense feel on the string. But our hybrid Fovea is a different beast altogether. The hybrid Fovea plays a lot softer than a Surveil. It has power, which you can feel, but it's dispersed over a larger unit, making for a softer play on the string. It's also wider than the Surveil, which allows for a little more user-friendliness. It's very stable and just makes yo-yoing a bit more easier and a bit more pleasurable than the Surveil or the Iceberg. Now, I can't compare the two Icebergs. I had the original, the skinnier version, but they say the wider version is a little more palatable. And if that's the case, then so is this yo-yo because it's wider as well. In my opinion, this translates into a very solid feeling, comfortable, and accommodating yo-yo. That's the word I'm looking for, accommodating. Typically, I take out two yo-yos per day when I'm working, just to give myself a little mix-up. But I can actually take this out as my EDC by itself and be thoroughly satisfied with its performance. To me, this is better than the Iceberg. I love the Surveil, and it is better than the Iceberg as well, but I love both for different reasons. When the Iceberg first hit, it broke new ground. But this hybrid Fovea, well, it plants its flag, and to me, It wears the crown as far as I'm concerned. Yeah. Modern, fluid, beautiful. So the question I pose now, dear viewer, is this. Will you be missing this yo-yo? Or will you be landing this yo-yo? Comment below and let me know what you really think. In the meantime, check out what we get into for next time. Okay, this has been the Hybrid Fovea Yo-Yo Review by Jeffrey Pang and Lutzwerk. A dope situation. You know how we do. And I do love this thing. I've been playing it every day since I got it. All right, y'all. I'm Simply Mike, and I will check you guys out in the next video. Peace.